Hey fellow gamers, Chatty Sisa here. This is an update on the modding guide that I did last year for the Frosty mods and for Mass Effect Andromeda. That one is already more than a year old by now. I did it in, January 2024. And since then, there have been a couple of changes, some more significant, some others not, but they still will affect your modding at this point. And what I want to highlight here is this is not a complete walkthrough again from scratch or from the start, and that is simply because the original modding guide is still for the most part valid. So there is a point in the modding guide where you, let's say, technically need to stop and do something different, and that is what I explain here in this guide. So that means you can still use the original one for the first setup, the majority of the steps, and then here is an update. And also, I did pick up on all the newest issues that the people have been posting throughout the past few months, which were the most common ones, and I'm providing here also a solution for those issues that you might encounter, which are new compared to the original guide. So I do hope that you will be finding this guide useful, and on this spot I also want to thank you already in advance for watching, for posting any comments, and for liking this vid if you find it very useful. It would be really great if you would hit that like button below. And also, please don't hesitate to ask me any questions in the comment sections if you have any issues that are maybe not mentioned. Thank you. Before you start, an important information first. Please notice the versions of the files I'm using and showing in the original modding guide. The Frosty Mod Manager is available on various sites these days with different versions. Especially after the release of Dragon Age The Veilguard in November 2024, it looks like it's been updated on some sites to allow the modding for Veilguard. Unfortunately, that newer version is not fully compatible with Mass Effect Andromeda and is causing some issues. Mass Effect Andromeda requires the Frosty Mod Manager version as shown in the vid. You can find that version still available on GitHub if you follow the steps in the guide. If you use a different version, you will most probably run into the same issues as described by one of the viewers. You might be able to load mods, but every modified texture is broken with a checkered pattern. All mods are causing visual glitches. These are not mod specific, even though they load fine. In general, I've used all of the versions, whether mods, tools, apps, etc. for my modding, as you can see in the vid. The versions should be visible for each part. When I looked at GitHub, there's a new tool suite in development, but that's not working yet, and they are redirecting to the version Frosty tool suite 1.0.6.3, which also contains the mod manager that I've used for my modding. And the game's version for Mass Effect Andromeda that I have is 1.10. The original modding guide, as well as a list of mods I've used for my playthrough, are both linked in the description below. The original modding guide is also necessary for this updated one. As the old modding guide is for the most part still valid, after considering the previous information, you can now watch and follow the original modding guide up to approximately the 17th minute, where the guide says to start the game through the launch button directly in the Frosty Mod Manager. The new update on this spot is: if you've bought the game through Steam, then be aware that it had an update last year in March, which surprisingly resulted in us all being able to launch the modded game directly through the Steam launch button. I'd say it has fixed some issues with the game being stuck on launch, as the communication between the mod manager, the Steam, and the EA apps wasn't always working smoothly, so this should work nicely without having to launch it through the mod manager now. Launching the game through the Steam launch button should automatically load all the mods you've installed previously through the Frosty Mod Manager. If it does not yet work and the game launches in an unmodded state, or you run into error messages, then you have to go back to the original modding guide and continue from approximately the 20th minute with installing the necessary fixes like the DatapathFix and the Frosty Fix. This is due to the fact that Steam can still clash with the EA app, which is a known troublemaker for modded games and oftentimes is the root cause for game launch issues. Let's also not forget this is a Frostbite engine game, and that in itself represents a challenge for successful modding. The following known older issues and their proposed solutions are described already in the old modding guide at approximately the 34th minute mark. Unmodded vanilla game not working, Frosty Fix not working, unable to install mods after applying DatapathFix. Please see the original guide for the resolutions of those. However, there are also some additional new issues which have popped up in the months following the original guide, and here's the most common ones and their solution. A pop-up window saying, "One or more symbolic links could not be created. Please restart the tool as admin and ensure your storage drive is formatted NTFS. As a viewer pointed out, make sure to not just extract the contents of the Frosty Mod Manager folder in the zip file, but also the folder itself. For this, please make sure to follow the original guide closely at the 1.5 minute and the 7th minute mark. A pop-up window saying the given key was not present in the dictionary. This is an issue related specifically to the Frosty Mod Manager. There are more suggestions to be found online as there are multiple reasons possible for this error message. Verify your game files through Steam first. Some files might be broken or missing after installing the Frosty Mod Manager. Once you verify, Steam will include the missing or repair the broken files and you can continue working with the Mod Manager. Go to C, Users, Your Username, App Data, Local, Frosty, and there delete the Manager Config JSON file. Delete alternatively the Frosty folder from your C, User, Local, App Data entirely. You need to look also in the hidden files on your PC here to be sure you've completely removed everything and then reinstall anew. Make sure that if you're using a mod where you have multiple options to choose from, that you only download and install the one you actually want to use, not all of them. This is always clearly specified in each such mod on Nexus Mods. For example, if you have a mod with 4 different variations of a jacket and the mod's description says select only one, then do not download all 4 options. If you have modded the game already a long time ago, I had a viewer mention for example 2.5 years, and now the mods are no longer working, it's very likely that this is caused due to multiple updates on all the apps and tools in the meantime. For example, the EA app was migrated, the game is now having a higher version, the Frosty Mod Manager is updated, etc. As we found out, the solution here is unfortunately to reinstall the game now, install the DatapathFix, the FrostyFix, and make sure the mods are enabled globally under FrostyFix. For the correct installation and setup of the DatapathFix and FrostyFix, please see the original guide at approximately the 20th minute mark. The hair mods don't work. Please choose the specific preset already in the character creator as shown in my vid with the list of the mods that I've used for my playthrough. Some hair mods require very specific presets to be chosen before you even start the game, otherwise they won't be visible in an already ongoing playthrough. Also, please don't forget to set the mesh setting to ultra as mentioned there. When no mods are working at all. If you followed all the steps and can launch the game but still see no mods, then one of the possible issues that causes this is that you have the game installed twice. There have been instances where people have, for example, bought the original game a long time ago via the EA app and installed it. Then later on there was a sale, for example on Steam, offering multiple games bundled together, and one of those could have been Andromeda. If you've installed that complete bundle, you have now installed Mass Effect Andromeda twice, once through EA and once through Steam, meaning you're having two different game folders for it. If the game is installed more than once, primarily because this is an EA game, the launching of it will always default to the EA app folder, and the Steam folder game files have a lower launch priority. If you set up the Mod Manager and DatapathFix or Frosty Fix all to be directed towards the Steam game folder, you won't see any mods, simply because in reality you're running the unmodded game from the EA folder in the background. So the solution is either to make sure you direct and link your Mod Manager, DatapathFix and Frosty Fix to the game files in the EA folders and not to Steam, or make sure you uninstall the game from either EA or Steam and you only have the game on your PC once in only one folder. The last issue I've seen popping up for some players: Steam won't launch the game even if the EA app was opened first. It starts the preparing game pop-up and then that one closes, the EA app opens, and that's it. The game won't load. So you're not exactly stuck on that preparing game pop-up, but the game just simply doesn't start. In this case, the problem could be, once again as usual, the EA app itself. Please completely log out of EA, then go to the Task Manager, stop all EA-related processes there, because instead of one, it is in reality oftentimes showing multiple sessions running at the same time, which is causing the issue. Then restart the PC and log in again into EA. You should be able to start the game now through the Steam launch button. The Frosty tool suite is not just the Mod Manager, but also, for example, the Mod Editor and some other resources valuable for modders. So the Mod Manager is just one part of it, but it's an individual app which runs on its own, so you don't need the whole suite, just the Mod Manager as I've shown in the video. Please be aware that if you already have an ongoing playthrough and you start to apply some mods in the middle of it, some might work, others not. Especially mods that, for example, affect riders or the companions' looks, some textures on characters like the Turian's Restored mod, etc., can cause issues as these need to be normally applied before you start a game. If you try to apply these types of mods mid-game, they will either not load at all or they will break the game. Therefore, in general, I would advise you to mod the game before you start a new playthrough. In case this needs to be said, this modding guide will not work with a cracked game, only with the original, either bought directly from EA or through Steam. Aside from the cheap research mod, which I've mentioned in my original guide, which is not working and can cause issues with launching the game, there was also another mod highlighted by one of the viewers to be causing the game to freeze on start. It is the Power Spec mod. It looks like it might be clashing with some other mods, so if you can't start the modded game and you've previously installed this mod, try to first disabling or uninstalling it and see if this doesn't fix the issue. And last but not least, an information for Windows 11 users who are connecting the Frosty Mod Manager and Steam for the first time. This guide was created originally for those who use Windows 10 64-bit version. I probably should have mentioned it last year, but nevertheless, there is, as per the information from one of my viewers, only a minor difference to a Windows 11 64-bit installation. And in Windows 11, in general, I think more convenient when connecting the Frosty Mod Manager with Steam. As you can see, the post from the viewer says, I was fortunate and using an unmodded, never used Steam version of Andromeda on Windows 11 64-bit. I was able to install and start Frosty, use the auto-find games, worked I suspect because the game and Frosty were on C drive, and launch the game from Frosty, no mods yet, so that Frosty installed itself in Steam. After that, I was able to start the game from Steam. I did not need any of the optional fixes, and fingers crossed, as I go in hunt of mods, my luck continues. So it looks like it will be much easier for you if you have Windows 11 in connecting the apps in the background. I hope this update on the guide was useful for you and helped you resolve any issues. Thank you very much for watching, stay tuned, and game on!